Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel guys. In today's video we'll be working on a Ford Focus MK3 guys. This is the third generation Ford Focus from year 2012 to year guys 2019. And we'll show you if you need to replace your AC condenser, okay, if it's leaking or you need to replace it, how to do that now guys. Stay with us, quick introduction. We have more than 200 videos on Ford Focus and more than 200 videos on every car we get at the shop. Why? Because our mission here at the shop is to save you guys as much money as we can. So please subscribe to the channel and like the video. Hopefully guys you will find the information helpful. Now if you guys want to buy replacement parts or you want to save on parts and tools, check out the link in the description of the video below. You can get them for a super good price, fast shipping as well. Another thing guys, you can remove that condenser now in two different ways: the condenser only or the radiator, condenser and radiator shutter together. This one will be the route that I'll go probably, because it's way easier. Otherwise you can break things in the car. So we'll go ahead, remove everything and show you how to disassemble it outside of the car. For that purpose you need to drain your radiator coolant guys. Okay, your coolant and the radiator, because we'll be removing the radiator as well. You can skip that step if you want to guys, but stay with us, we'll explain how to do that. You will need to drain the coolant only when the car is extremely cold, so let it sit overnight, otherwise it can hurt you guys. Coolant will be under pressure and will be super hot. That can burn you guys severely. Now, we'll go ahead, do that, and we'll show you guys what needs to be done to remove and replace that AC condenser. Let's start on it now. So we need a Torx 30 guys. Okay, Torx 30, start looking beat. Okay, and we're going to go ahead and start removing screws underneath. Okay, you can see 1, 2, then we have one more in the other corner there. Okay, 2 screws, 3 screws so far guys. Now we have more that we need to remove. We're going to start from the passenger side now. 1, 2, 3 on the front. 3 in the rear, 3 in the front, guys. So now, okay, let's explain now. You grab it and you pull it forward. Pull it forward and drop it down. You can see just like that. And this is, guys, your engine here. And we just found out that we have an oil leak from the rear crankshaft seal right there, so we'll have a video how to fix that one as well. You should have 2 more guys in the corners, 1 there and 1 on the other side, but 2 are missing. Ours are missing. And the screws, what they look like? Okay, just like this one. So you can see, you can get an idea what it looks like now. And that's where your oil filter is located, and bottom of the engine as well. So now, how you guys remove the other cover? Okay, you're supposed to have a clip removal too guys, and you're supposed to have 2 clips now. Those 2 clips will be right there, one in the corner. Ours are completely missing guys, we don't have them. And so we need to start removing screws. You can see on the other side, okay, in front of the wheel we have 2 of them, okay, that we need to remove. And once we remove these 2, we come towards the middle. Okay, everything's very muddy on that engine. Let's do these 2 towards the wheel. Perfect. Now, we just have, I think, 1 more. You might have dust and sand stuck there, so be careful guys. Always wear eye protection as well. Grab it now guys, okay, and you pull that cover down, okay, just like that. And now that's where your radiators are, the active grill as well, radiator fan, all that is here. And that's the lower radiator support and the drain plug for the radiators as well. So you can see that's how we remove the engine covers. So every time guys you drain the coolant, what you need to do, you need to make sure that the car is not hot, you did not drive the car, let it sit overnight, at least for 1 night guys, so the coolant can get cool. Because otherwise if you're trying to drain the system or open the radiator cap, if it's hot, it's under pressure, it can sprain your eyes. Even when it's cold it could be under pressure, so always be careful and wear eye protection. But hot coolant guys can severely hurt you as well. So coolant is very poisonous. If you spill anywhere, always clean it, because if you have people consume that, or animals, pets guys, it kills them. It's super toxic. So Our car is very cold. We haven't driven it since last night, so we're going to open, okay, the coolant reservoir. We'll remove the radiator cap now. Perfect. Okay, it's out. That way it's not going to create any pressure and any vacuum, excuse me, and we'll be able to drain it. So let's explain now what else we need to do. So we go under the car, guys, on the left side now. We have the car jacked up, okay. And right there, that's where your drain plug is located. Check it out. So this drain plug, either you get it with a flat screwdriver, big screwdriver, and it's going to drain from right here, so you have to be careful so it doesn't drain on you. Or you guys turn it by hand, but flat, big flat head screwdriver, guys, it's going to work out. It just goes directly inside of it, okay, right here. And if you get a little bitty hose, you can install actually the hose and it will drain in a container that you have. That way you're not going to make a mess. So we'll get a hose, okay, you can see like this one, it's going to fit great. We're going to plug it in, so that way we don't make a mess, guys. And we'll get a flathead screwdriver, okay, right there. And there is one canal, okay, it's super, super windy today, by the way. Okay, one canal where the screwdriver goes in. And then you just start turning. Turn, 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 and check it out. Okay, and we let it drain, guys. That's it. Don't remove the whole thing because you're going to make a big mess. And we'll just let it drain for about 5 to 10 minutes and everything should be out of there. And let me check on top. Probably, yep, coolant reservoir is already empty here. So make sure, guys, you stay until the end. We're going to show you a trick how to effectively actually drain the coolant and how to get more coolant out of the engine, because by flushing it, draining the radiator, you will not always get everything out of the engine. So while it's draining, guys, on the bottom, okay, let me explain to you quick. It's almost stopping, guys, check it out. Barely going, almost nothing. Now if we remove one of the caps here, okay, that cap, let me turn the light on quick, just squish it on the bottom, on the back side, gently pull it out. I dropped it, but it's okay. Now get the air compressor, okay, we have the air compressor, and we're going to blow air, okay, through that hole, and check out what's going to happen. Okay, let's do that now. Okay, check out how much more, guys, we're getting out of the engine. Okay, let me move the bucket just a little bit. Okay, perfect. And that way, guys, we can get most of it out. Okay, check out, we just got even more. So that's definitely helping it come out. We're blowing at low pressure now. We're blowing at about 20 PSI. And even the system is ready to stay at about 21. So we don't need much, guys, but definitely helped us get more. And we're going to install the cap now. So we're going underneath now and we're going to go ahead. Okay, it stopped coming out. So let's just get the screwdriver in, okay, and we just get it tight, guys. Okay, perfect. Don't over tighten it. Okay, that's it. Great, and we're going to remove the hose and we're going to get all the coolant that we got out of the car, and you will see how much it is in just a second. So let's pull the container out and we're going to see what it looks like. This is original coolant, 149,000 miles. So still not too bad. Okay, a little bit murky, but not bad. We'll definitely be replacing it. Now, guys, when you refill your system, it's very important to bleed the cooling system the correct way. We'll have the video on the channel that explains how to bleed your cooling system the correct way. Otherwise, guys, you can overheat the car and you can damage your engine and end up needing either a new engine or the old engine rebuilt. We get, guys, a flathead screwdriver. Let me explain now. This is your air filter box right here, guys. So what we need to do, okay, that right here is your MAF sensor. You need to unlock the red pin, okay, safety pin, grab it and pull up, guys. Okay, check it out, like that. And you push right here and you disconnect it. Now, you have one clip that you need to remove with a clip remover too. Okay, perfect, just like that. It's disconnected now, it's not there. After that, guys, we need to get a screwdriver, flathead screwdriver, and we need to get that screw loose there. This is for the intake boot. Now we have to be careful when you remove it to make sure that you don't break any of the vacuum lines as well. So be extremely, guys, careful how you do that. So we need to get it a little bit more loose. It wasn't loose enough to come out. It will be a tight fit, guys. Okay. Perfect, it came loose. So what we need to do after that, right here, we're going to pull, okay, like that. And now, guys, what we'll need to do, we need to grab that box. Okay, that box should not have any screws, guys. Okay, this box, it should be to where you just grab it and pull it out. Okay, you will have a clip on the back side, one right there. Okay, one clip there. You have a couple more here. So once we pull it out, I'll be able to explain, okay, where that clip is located. All the clips, actually. Okay, now, right here, we need to disconnect the rubber bushing from that pipe. Okay, perfect. Now we lift it up. Where are all the clips? Okay, let's explain now. You have one right there. Okay, this is towards the back side, facing the box this way. Okay, one here, and one over there, and one towards the front. Where they attach to? One here. You have, that's where it gets air from. One here, that's where the water actually drains. One here, one there, and one over there, guys. You can see this is if the engine gets water. I think it's called like resonator or something like that. It's supposed to drain there so it doesn't get in the engine. But if you drive through high water, you're going to end up, guys, sucking water in the engine and probably ruining your engine anyway. So we got the air filter box out of the way. So with 10 millimeter socket, guys, we're going to remove now, okay, one bolt for that lower part of the air filter box right there. So let's go ahead, remove that now. Okay, perfect. And it's out of the way. We gain more room to the radiator fan, radiators here, and everything in the way. So in the meantime, guys, we'll be making a few videos how to remove and replace radiators. You can just remove the whole radiator assembly with the fan and everything out of the way. But in our case, we'll do them one at a time. So depending, guys, okay, what you're needing now. Also make sure, guys, you disconnect your car battery because the radiator fan is right there, and if your fingers get stuck in it and for some reason it decides to turn on because you break a wire or something, it could happen, guys. Your fingers will be there, and as a result, guys, it can cut your fingers off or your hands, so be extremely careful. We already disconnected ours. Now, what we need to do right here, guys, we need to go ahead and remove, okay, that wire. Okay, let me get a little bit of light. Perfect. Okay, I press in here and pull out. Okay, let me show you where now. Okay, right there, press in, pull out. Now, guys, we have that clip holding the cable to the radiator fan with the clip removal tool. We're trying to pop it loose. Okay, perfect. What do we have now, guys? Okay, we have two guides holding the fan towards the radiator. Okay, one here and one exactly like that on the other side. However, now we need to go on the bottom, guys, underneath, and we'll show you guys, okay, what we need to do there. Okay, right there, you can see the radiator fan on the side. Okay, here there is one tooth. Once we remove it, we'll show even better. That tooth, you need to press it in with a screwdriver. Okay, right there. And while you're pressing it in, I'm going to pull it on top, okay, to come out. Okay, and it came out, guys. Now we need to do exactly the same thing on the other side. So let me go to the passenger side now. We're going to do the same thing there. So grab the fan. One person releases the tooth. Okay, it came up. Now, let me show you guys what else we need to do. We need to come, okay, on this side. And we need to lift the fan until it comes out of the guide. Okay, on this side is out all the way. The other side as well. And now we start dropping it, guys. Okay, now there is insulation here. Let me get it loose. Okay, this insulation is between the fan. Okay, in between the fan and the radiator as well. Okay, Okay, almost there. Okay, perfect. Now, we're hitting a little bit on the radiator hose. Okay, right there. But now it should come out. And you just pull it from underneath, guys. Okay, check it out now. Radiator fan is out, guys. So, that's how we removed it out of the car. Let me show you what we were pressing here. Okay, with the screwdriver, so you know what to expect. Right here, guys. Okay, this is the clip on the bottom. So, you need to press it in with the screwdriver while one person is pulling it up. And the same clip on the other side. Two clips on the bottom and two just guides on top. And that's how we removed it out of the way. So now, right here, we have one little bitty hose, the overflow bottle hose. Okay, I'm trying to get a little bit of a view, but it's almost impossible. There are two things that you squish and you pull it out. Okay, and that thing is stuck, guys, big time. You don't want to break it. Because that's one expensive hose. So eventually that thing will come out. It has one clip there. So, okay, let me show you what the hose looks like. Okay, like this one, guys. Like that. Okay, and you squeeze these two parts and you, okay, pull it apart. There is one O-ring that gets stuck really big time. That's why it came out a little bit hard. Now, we need to go underneath, guys. We need to get a 10 millimeter socket and we're going to remove the lower radiator support. Okay, make sure that coolant, guys. Okay, the coolant is drained and all that. Okay, so now, guys, what do we have here? Okay, we have a few clips that we need to disconnect. Okay, this is for the I think one is for the active grill shutter. We'll see. So just pull them out of the radiator support. Okay, almost came out. Perfect, this one is out, guys. Now we need to disconnect it from there as well. Okay, on the inside you can see. Almost out. And now we have the one on top there that we need to disconnect. Perfect. Underneath, we have the bolts for the lower radiator support now. 10 millimeter socket. And we're going to remove a few bolts, but we need to get a ratchet or extension, guys. A new battery for the impact because it's a little bit cold at the shop and it died. Okay, those things are extremely tight, by the way. Okay, we got a little bit longer extension that way. Okay, we can have a little bit more, okay, reach, because it's not as easy to reach the upper bolts, okay, for that lower radiator support. We got them loose. We'll try to use the impact now and see what's going to happen, if it's going to help some. You can see where all the bolts are. They have a little bit of rust. That's what the bolt looks like. Second one. Okay, now, guys, same thing. Okay, like what we did here, we need to do to the other side. So I'm going to switch places now. Okay, give me a second. And I'll go to the passenger side of the vehicle. Passenger side, let's remove a few things here so you can see. Okay, right there. So one of them is missing here. Oh, no, nope, it's on the back. Or it's missing. No, no, it's good, it's good. It's towards the back. I cannot just see it from that angle here. So two bolts on each side. Perfect. Now, gently guys, pull that thing out of the radiator on the bottom. Okay, one is out. Now on the other side, same thing. Okay, perfect. And the lower radiator support, guys, came out of the way. Okay, just like that, you can see. So guys, in order to remove the AC condenser, you don't have to remove the radiator. Now, you can see we removed the radiator fan to get a little bit of room, but you don't have to do that. What we'll do, we'll actually remove our radiator. We'll make a video how to replace the radiator as well. But we're going to, guys, remove it so we can show you how to do that. But otherwise, okay, disconnecting the radiator from the AC condenser is the same way, and you don't have to remove the radiator, you can just pull the condenser out. The easier way is to remove both of them at the same time. And but in that case, you have to drain your coolant, you have to remove the radiator and install it later as well. Now, stay with us, we're going to do that and we'll continue. So now we have very limited room. I won't be able to show you anything, guys, with the camera. So what we decided to do, we're going to remove the radiator and the condenser at the same time. So that way we can show you guys with a great detail, okay, where everything is once we get them out of the car. Otherwise, it's impossible, guys, for us to stick that camera in such limited room. So we need to get a 13 millimeter socket. Our AC system is already drained. If it's not drained, guys, if you remove those lines, it'll be super. Enormous amount of pressure, it can hurt you, blind you guys, so you have to be careful. AC system needs to be completely empty when you do that. So okay, let's go ahead and remove it. You have to be extremely careful when you remove it to make sure that you still don't have any pressure left, guys. So let's go ahead, take that. Okay, a little bit came out, just a little bit of pressure. Let's remove it. Yeah, very little, guys, very little. It just sprayed, but that's it. Even though we vacuum the system down, we still have just a little bit of pressure. So you have two lines that you need to remove. One is the low pressure, I think. One is the high pressure line. So, okay, check it out. That's how it came out. And now we have the other one that you need to remove. It's towards the front, guys. So we need to tilt that thing the other way a little bit somehow. Okay, I'll hold it like that. Okay, and 10 millimeter socket there. No, this one doesn't want to come loose too. Those are pretty, pretty tight, guys, but keep in mind that this is a higher mileage car. Okay, came loose. So now we should be able to do it with the impact. Okay, this one came loose as well. Both of them came loose. The bolt fell underneath. Okay, let me grab it quick. Okay, you can see where the bolt is. Right there. We dripped a little bit of oil, guys. So we're loose on that side. We just pull the radiators, the whole assembly down. We have two radiator hoses to disconnect. Okay, one will be on this side. So if we grab the radiator and pull it a little bit to the passenger side, okay, let's see if we can do that. We might be able to reach that hose, guys, okay, with the pliers. Okay, let's see with the other ones if we can remove that hose clamp, because this one is on a very weird angle. I don't know if it's been removed before or not, or it's just that way. So okay, let me try that now. Nope, we have to do it with the other pliers probably. So we have the coolant removed now too, guys. Okay, you can see almost came out. Okay, I'm going to grab the hose to hold it steady for the person that is removing the clamp. Never stick your fingers under the hose clamp, because when it releases, that thing is going to snap. Okay, it's almost out. We are about to jump the lip. Okay, let me actually give... Okay, these pliers right there, the other pair. We'll try with the vice grips. This is one tough clamp, guys. Really, really tough hose clamp. So let's try with the other pliers, right there. Okay, perfect. It came loose, guys. Now, we'll go ahead and remove the other one on the other side. Okay, before we remove that one, because we'll still leak some coolant. So I will not disconnect it until we remove the other hose, guys. Let me show you where the other hose is located now. Okay, it's located. Okay, let's get in here. It's located right there. Okay, where it goes in an angle, you can kind of see it. Okay, perfect. So what we're going to do now, eye protection always, guys, gloves, because that's coolant. We'll go ahead and pull the hoses out. Okay, you can see we did leak some out. Okay, perfect. Now we're going to go to the other side. I'm going to grab this one, okay? We're ready now. Okay, it's coming out. Almost there. Okay, we'll leak coolant out, so be careful now. Okay, not much. Perfect. Now, okay, let me come right here, guys. Okay, the radiator assembly will come out. Okay, you can see just like that. So, what we thought, guys, that we can remove the radiator only. I don't think it's possible, because we have the active grill shutter on the front. And that active grill shutter actually, guys, okay, mounts to the radiator, okay, and between that is the AC condenser, the other radiator. So we practically, guys, will not be able to disconnect them without removing the active grill shutter. And that could be a little bit tricky. So we'll go ahead and see how to do that now, and we'll see if you can do it in the car. But probably the easiest thing is to remove everything together and do it outside. I don't say that it's not possible, but probably it will be easier that way. So how you guys disconnect the active grill shutter from the radiators? Pretty simple, right there underneath. Let's lift it up a little bit so I can show you. There is one tooth, guys. Okay, one tooth that you need to press in with a screwdriver. And when you press it in, okay, what you're going to do? Okay, you're going to lift it up. So I think this can be done in the vehicle, guys. I don't know if you have enough room on top, but I think you will. Same thing applies, okay, to this side. Now right here, this is where the tooth is. Okay, and you can see actually it came out pretty easy, not as complicated as I thought it would be. So now we're going to show you how to separate the AC condenser from the radiator. Let's do that quick, guys. What you need to do now, okay, get the both radiators, and we have a few clips. Okay, one is right here on top. Okay, let us show you that clip right here. You need to lift it up, and when you lift it up, you grab the condenser and you pull it out. Now a little bit, I think. Okay, like that. Now we have on the other side one more thing. Okay, let me explain where now and how to do that as well. Here you have a double clip, one here, one on the bottom. So go ahead. Okay, go ahead and spread it, guys. Okay, I'll hold it here with one hand. Now we're going to do the bottom one. Okay, and we almost started coming out. We just need to, guys, okay, push it with the screwdriver a little bit, because I think both sides got loose. The one on top is loose already. Okay, perfect. We just need to push it out. Okay, great. And now you lift the condenser out. You can see, not too complicated once everything is out, but in the vehicle it may be way, way more complicated. So, as you can see, that's how you remove the condenser, guys. Okay, in my opinion, it practically will not be possible to remove the condenser without a radiator. Some people say it's possible, but it's really complicated. If you're at that point, I would recommend just drain your coolant, guys. Remove the radiator, remove the condenser, the whole assembly, and later install, okay, put new coolant in your system. And it's very important to bleed the cooling system the correct way. Otherwise, guys, if you don't bleed it the correct way, you can overheat your engine, and that can cost you a new engine, guys. So hopefully the video will be helpful to any of you that their condenser need to be replaced, and maybe your AC air conditioner didn't work because of a bad condenser. So hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching, and see you guys next time.